Portions of TV23's Internet provided by SWKO Wireless Internet. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information. From TV23 Studios in Sublette, this is High Plains Today.
Yes, it is. Welcome to High Plains Today, everybody. It is Thursday, February 9th, 2017. Welcome to the show. You know what on today's show? She's one of my faves. McKensie Hood, she is the executive director of the Seward County United Way. They just got done with their big pledge drive, et cetera, et cetera. Plus, they got another little activity coming up we're going to talk about. In the meantime, let's take a look at happenings. The Dodge City Community College Board of Trustees will need to fill the seat of Trustee Don Webb, who submitted his resignation back on January 27th. William Hammond of Dodge City has announced his candidacy for the college trustee position. Hammond is currently the Executive Director of Business and Operations for Dodge City USD 443 School District. Hammond has also been very outspoken against Dodge City Community College selling land for retail development. While fees were not waived for the use of the county building by a local nonprofit, that agency will still get to use the building thanks to the generosity of one of the Seward County commissioners. A group of 40 volunteers from Southern Illinois College's Students Today Leaders Forever group is coming to Liberal to assist the 61-people mosaic in Liberal serves with an art day March 14th at the Seward County Activity Center. Now, some county commissioner said part of the criteria for a waiver of fees had not been met due to the event being restricted to mosaic's clients. Chairman Nathan McCaffrey said the public purpose requirement is based on Kansas law. Well, Commissioner Ada Linenbroker is willing to spend some of the Society for the Prevention of Board Housewives craft show money to pay the $225 to allow them to use the facility. Good job, Ada. And Western Kansas Manufacturers Association announced on Monday that scholarships are available to high school seniors who plan on attending an area four-year college, junior college, or vocational college for the 2017-18 school year. Now, WKMA is a sponsor of the annual 3i show that takes place in Dodge City. Funds for the scholarships are partially provided by the sale of the 300 limited edition belt buckles commemorating the 3i show. Now, the scholarships are available to students who graduated from Western Kansas High School and currently reside in that area. Need to see your school counselor about that. And a Senate panel moved Tuesday to cut $128 million from K-12 education and $23 million from higher education in Kansas. Now, those are reductions that would take effect this fiscal year to help fill a budget shortfall. Now, today, Republican leaders have canceled that debate on budget balancing proposals because they could not sell GOP colleagues on education funding cuts. The Senate had planned to debate the bill today. Several GOP senators thought the cut in aid to public schools was too steep, with only months left in the school year. And a small Oklahoma town is echoing the storyline of the 80s movie Footloose by canceling a Valentine's Day dance because of an arcane city ordinance enforcing a strict moral code. The organizer canceled the dance in Henrietta, Oklahoma, because it would have taken place 300 feet from a church in violation of an ordinance that forbids dancing within 500 feet of a place of worship. Mayor Jennifer Clausen, who was born in Henrietta, says she always knew about the old ordinance, but that it has never been enforced. Now, Police Chief Steve Norman says his department has no plans or interest in enforcing it. Clausen says the city councilors will consider abolishing the ordinance during their next meeting on February 22nd. All right, you know what? We're getting close. Today we're going to give one of these away. You want to register for one of our 30-ounce Yeti cups with our TV23 logo on it? All you got to do, send me a postcard. TV23 KDGL PO Box 447 Sublette America 67877. Or if you want to do it really, really super easy, send us an email, cup@kdgltv.com. All you got to do is put your name and address on the entry. This week's winner is, are we ready? Here it comes. Martin Knopp of Tyrone. Martin, we're going to get this baby in the mail to you, so be looking for it. All right, going to warm up a little bit today, a lot tomorrow and on Saturday, but we're going to drop back off on Sunday. Take a look at the forecast when we come back.
You're watching High Plains Today on TV 23 with host Chris Jewell.
TV 23's internet service and 4G live streaming provided by United Wireless. Coverage you deserve. Service you expect. United Wireless.
Never miss your favorite TV shows again. With TiVo from Pioneer Communications, you can record up to 6 shows at once and then watch them in any room of the house. It's out of this world TV entertainment, and it's only from Pioneer Communications. Your community connected.
Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV 23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays, here on TV 23.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
I did. Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you know that strollers have the right of way on the sidewalk?
Yes.
Yep, I did. Did you guys
did
know?
You know that kids who eat breakfast have higher GPAs?
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Yeah. That's actually what I was going to say.
Did you know babies should never touch silver? It's really bad for them.
I knew that.
Did you guys know that statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat at the right age and size. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
I'm putting that on my blog.
I just put it in mine.
Now, the local weather forecast for the High Plains.
Hey, we got a lot of sunshine out there again today. We're going to have a lot of sunshine today. It's going to warm up. Tell you what, we take a look at the temperature right now. Yesterday it was like 31 degrees at this time. Look at that, 45 already. Relative humidity 50%. Winds are out of the south, southeast at 12. Barometric pressure is going falling. Taking a look at the current temperatures around the area. Now you can see, all right, today. Now this is going to get a little goofy because you get out here around Elkhart, Guymon, all the way over to Liberal. This area you could see into the 50s, 60s, maybe 70s today, but the further east you go, Medicine Lodge, you may get into the 40s today, so that's just the kind of day it's going to be. Looking at the current dew point, so everybody pretty dry. You may want to break out the hand lotion, maybe a little chapstick today if you're feeling a little dry. Winds, though, we're going to have some winds today. They're going to pretty much stay out of the south, southerly direction, southeast, southwest. Today, you can see the biggest wind is 22 down at Guymon. Dodge City is coming in at 24. Here's the highs and lows as recorded at the Garden City Regional Airport yesterday. We only got to 35 for the high. 74 back in 1976. Overnight low was 14 minus 5 back in 1980. Yeah, no new precipitation in the bucket. All right, today we're going to call for lots of sunshine. Wind's going to be out of the south at about 17 to 20 miles an hour. 64 is going to be our high. Tonight, mostly clear. It's going to warm up overnight, actually, as it gets lower. 40 degrees overnight. Winds are going to stay out of the south. Switching around to the west, southwest tomorrow. Yeah, that's an 83 for tomorrow. Lots of sunshine. Winds are going to calm down a little bit. Be out of the west tomorrow. Under 10 miles an hour. Maybe shorts and flip-flop weather tomorrow. I don't know. 49 for the overnight low. Partly cloudy. Winds are still going to be out of the south and the west at 10. Then as we get into the weekend, we got a little precipitation maybe rolling in. Look at that, we're going to be 83 tomorrow, 79 on Saturday. Then there is a cold front that's moving in from the southwest. It's going to come, a low pressure is going to move in here, maybe bring us a chance of some precipitation, only 20%, but I think it's going to stay south of the Kansas-Oklahoma border also on Monday. But you get into the rest of the week, starting Valentine's Day, going to be 54. Hey, it's February, people. I can live with that. That's a look at the weather. Be back with the markets and McKensie after this.
Remember when you found that thing you thought you'd never see again?
Honey!
All right!
The Kansas State Treasurer's Office doesn't have your old baseball glove.
There you are!
But they do have over $300 million in unclaimed cash.
Yes.
And some of it could be yours. For information about how you can find your unclaimed cash, find us on Facebook or go to kansascash.com.
Hi, I'm Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs at noon weekdays right here on TV23. Hey, do you think you have an idea for something that would make a great segment? Somebody that would make a great interview? What about a community event that needs highlighting? Let us know here at the station. Email us, news@kbgltv.com.
Money on wasted electricity. You're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
I used to think news is news. It's all the same, but it's not. There's a big difference between local broadcast news and cable news. See, local stations are part of my community, connecting me to local news, weather, and sports on every device. It makes sense. Get the news from the people I trust who actually live here. No agenda, no bias like on cable shout shows or social media, just facts. For news I can trust, I stay local. Support your local stations. Text TV to 52886 today.
Same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free tips to help you save, go to Feed the Pig.
traditional light bulbs actually generate 9 times more heat than light. Switch to Energy Star light bulbs, and you'll realize just how much cash you are really burning through. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
That's funny. Welcome back. I am joined by one of my favorites. It's McKensie Hood. She is the executive director of the Seward County United Way Liberal America, but you do more than Seward County and Liberal.
Yes, we do. We're kind of all over. I tell everyone we're out here by ourselves, and so we got to help each other out.
There you go. Yeah. Good to see you today.
Yeah, good to see you.
I haven't seen you for several months.
I know. It's been a while. It's been too long.
I know. You need to get more stuff going.
You got to call me more, I guess.
Yeah. I call her, and she goes, no, I really don't have anything today.
Oh, that's not true. I got a lot going on. Now
does.
I do.
She
I
does.
A lot going on.
Yeah, she get into the busy seat. You got to start making some money. Well, no.
We've been making money.
You're still taking donations, right?
Yes, we
if
are.
If somebody wants to donate, you're not going to say, nope, we're full.
Nope, I'm going to take it with a big smile on my face.
But you had your big fundraising campaign that you kicked off earlier in the fall.
Yes,
we and did. And you made your goal,
yes,
right?
Yes, we officially have hit 100%. So we raised $340,000, maybe a little bit more. But again, we're still taking donations. And so hopefully that number just keeps going up.
Because now going into this year, you had what, 24 agencies?
Yes.
But you added another. So now you serviced what, 25 agencies?
25 agencies. And we've actually had a couple more nonprofits, local nonprofits. Call and ask how they can maybe become a United Way agency and how they can get that funding and go through our allocation process. So this year, our allocation process will take place. The applications are due in December, and then the actual interviews will happen in 2018, March in 2018. And so the more money we raise, the more agencies that we can accept and add on to our umbrella of United Way agencies.
So you just keep humming right along.
Yep.
I noticed your big sign there in front of the Memorial Library. It had all the footballs all the way up through. So.
Well, it has been only up to 90% because I tried to stick the 100% football on and it was too wet outside and it lost the stickiness. So all I'm waiting on the other football, but we are at 100%. So.
Important safety tip. You can't put that stuff up when it's cold or raining.
That's exactly true. It was the day it was really foggy. I tried to put it up and take a picture, and it just didn't work very well. So we'll get it up probably tomorrow.
She's from Texas, people.
I am.
That's why. She's from Texas. I went to school at Oklahoma State. So if you're a KU or K-State person, that says a lot. Right
don't
there.
Hold it
you
against
don't
me.
Don't need to say any more. Although your husband's an OU person. So.
He is.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's
tied
rough.
In the wool.
That's
yeah.
rough.
All right. So... you got another deal coming up, though, in a couple of weeks. This is your second annual.
Yes, we're excited. So last year, we held our first Wine and Wings. Lyddon and Aero actually partnered with us, and they opened up their hangar that's attached to the office. And we kind of decorate it, and we have a huge wine tasting. It was so much fun last year. We had an amazing turnout. We're excited to do it again. We have more sponsors this year. So Lyddon and Aero, of course, is sponsoring. It's out at the hangar. Then we also have Rafter J's and Standard Beverage that help us out with the wine every year. And then we actually purchase the wine from them, but they do a monetary donation. And then Conestoga is a presenting sponsor as well. So we're really excited. It's just growing. We hope more people come out. You'll get to taste lots of different wines and different food pairings.
I was going to say, will there be snacks?
Yes, there's lots of
snacks.
That's
the important part.
There's
snacks.
Lots. That was my husband's favorite part last year was the salmon that we had. But yeah, lots of snacks. And we try to pair it with the wine. Todd from the Country Club actually caters that. And High Plains Pizza Hut is our sponsor for the food sponsor. So.
All right. So yeah. This is Wine and Wings. It's airplane wings, people.
Yes.
You're not
actually, we're having wings this year.
Wings and wings?
We had so many people walk in and go, wait, I thought it was wings as in like buffalo wings. Because Pizza Hut was our, you know, food sponsor,
well,
so they
yes.
put that together. But it's just a cute, catchy title. But this year, we're like, we're just going to go ahead and have wings.
Okay, so it's wine and wings and wings.
Yes, and if you're not a wine person, we also have a small table of a whiskey tasting, and we also have beer there as well.
I was going to say, well, what if you're not a whiskey person, though? But you could,
Yeah, we have all the bases covered.
You know, all right, and I don't know, you know, if you do this for a third year, you need to call the boys up at Boot Hill Distillery
in Dodge
City.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
That's
some good guys.
Yeah.
Hayes Kelman, who runs Boot Hill Distillery, he's been on a couple of times.
Well, that's awesome.
I'm sure he'd love to help you
out. You're full of good ideas.
I am a wealth of information, people.
Yes, you are. But anyways, we're super excited. It's on the 24th, February 24th. It's a Friday night. Starts at 6, goes to 11. Last year, we couldn't even get people to leave. They were having so much fun, which is a good thing. It's not a bad thing. So.
Go home.
Yes,
right?
That's kind of, we made them help us clean up.
Oh, there you go. That gets
yeah,
them out in a hurry.
But it was a lot of fun. It's a $50 suggested donation at the door for couples, and then $30 suggested donation at the door for singles. And that's just, the suggested donation is just pretty much a donation to United Way. We also raffle off different gift baskets, which is kind of fun. And then we do a wine pool where you can actually buy a wine cork. And then whatever number is on your wine cork goes with the bottle of wine that we've numbered. So it's just kind of a luck of the draw. You could get a $10 bottle of wine.
Yes.
You can get a $40 bottle of wine.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
How much is a cork?
$20.
Oh, that's not bad.
No. So.
All right. So what's in some of the gift baskets that you're going to give away?
Last year we did Spelon gave us a gift basket and it had different lotions and that kind of thing. Nick Hatcher actually picked that gift basket. He was our first winner. His wife uses the lotion, so it was kind of funny. But he got that gift basket. We did kind of like a Coca-Cola whiskey kind of themed one. There wasn't any whiskey actually in the basket because we can't raffle off alcohol. But it had like the Coca-Cola whiskey glasses, the little cute small Cokes, some I think like peanuts and, you know, that kind of stuff in there. We had a martini basket, which was the martini glasses and a shaker. And we had a margarita basket.
Did you have a jar of olives in the margarita?
Yes. Yes,
okay.
We did, of
just
course.
Right,
so different kind of drink-themed baskets is what we did. So it was a lot of fun. And we just did the drawings throughout the night. And, you know, as the night went on, people got way more excited and were buying more tickets and stuff like that. So it was a lot of fun. Definitely a fun event. We raise a lot of money for our agencies and for United Way.
That's the best part is, I mean, this is a fundraiser
for
United Way. And all the United Way funds stay in the communities.
Yes, they do.
Right?
Yep. They all stay local. Anything that you donate stays local. And then we just allocate it back out to our agencies. It doesn't stay with United Way personally. But, you know, for some of our agencies, it helps keep their lights on. Without the funding, that they literally can't even stay in the building. So. The more money we raise, like I said, the more we can do for our community and the more our local agencies can do for our community. So
that's the best part.
It is.
All right, people, because United Way does a ton of good things. And this is one of them. You want to go out and there's kind of some nice airplanes in that hangar out there, too.
Yes,
if you want to kind of go out there and go, wow, I wish I had one of those.
That's what a lot of people do. And they actually they bring out some of their older airplanes, the ones that have a lot of history and that kind of things. And they had little flyers set up to kind of explain what they were and what year they were and stuff like that. So Lyddon does an awesome job out there. They make the event, honestly, without them. Just wouldn't be wine and wings.
Lyddon boys, they like them airplanes. They like that flying stuff.
They do.
They've been doing it for a long time.
Yes, they have.
They're
they
kind
do
of
a good job, too.
All right, so this is Friday night, February 24th. It starts at 6 p.m., and it's out at the Liberal Airport. You can't miss it. You go to Lyddon Aero Center, right?
Yes.
Suggested donations, if you're like me and going to show up by yourself, it's going to cost you $30.
Mm-hmm.
That's an easy deal. If you have a couple, $50. In the door you go.
Yep.
You can hang out with airplanes. You can hang out with people. You can learn something about wine if you're like me and don't know nothing,
that's
right?
That's exactly true. I don't know.
Because I don't need you got your red, you got your whatever, and that's it.
Yep, that's exactly
all
true.
Right. McKensie, thanks for coming by today.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
You need to come around a little more often.
I know, I do.
All right.
I'll try.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks,
and I'll be back with about that much more right after this.
How it is, it's so clear. Oh, oh.
Just think, what if we didn't have local TV and radio? Where would I go for local sports, local politics, a mayor, city council, stuff that affects me every day? How about health? Who's covering things that endanger my family? I need to know now, as it happens, from sources I trust, people in my community. No agenda, no bias like you find on cable and social media, just facts. For news I can trust, I stay local. Support your local station. Text TV to 52886 today.
Clean kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
You know what? After becoming the winningest football coach at Mead, including class 2-1A championships in 2010 and 2012, in 10 years, the Wichita native Scott Mosier is going to leave a small southwestern Kansas town to accept the coaching position at Wichita's North High School. Now, not only will Mosier go from the smallest 11-man division to the largest, but he will also shift from being a building principal, which he was in Mead for the last 5 years, to teaching phys ed again. You know what? He's kind of excited about that. He likes all the interaction he gets with the students every day. All right, let's take a look at our weather before we get out of here. It's still warming up. It's 46 degrees out right now. Relative humidity, 48%. Winds are out of the south at 10. Barometric pressure is falling. All right, yeah, this is not a misprint on the 7 day as we look at it. Tomorrow, it's going to be 83. We're getting into the 60s today, 80s tomorrow, 70s on Saturday. Could be a bunch of wind on Saturday, but we do have slight chance of precipitation coming up on Sunday and Monday. But, you know, sunshine back on Tuesday and Wednesday. Go out and have a great Thursday, everybody. See you back here next time.
Keep up to date with the latest information from TV 23 on our Facebook page, KDGL-TV.
What is radon? Home exposure to radon gas is the leading cause of lung cancer death in the United States for non-smokers. In Kansas, 1 in 4 homes will test at or above the EPA action level. The Surgeon General recommends all homes be tested and fixed if necessary. Visit KansasRadonProgram.org for more information. Test, fix, save a life.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him going on to fascinate millions with his talent? 1 in 260,000. The odds of this born racer having 157 career top 10 finishes in NASCAR? 1 in 125 billion. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 88. I'm NASCAR driver Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
I feel when I'm right here.